Okay, my name is Kiona, and this is my final capstone project. Okay, so first off, I would like to start by showing you guys a couple pictures. This right here is my family. This is me, my spouse, our two children, Allison and Abe, right down there in the car seat. It's my sister-in-law, my two brother-in-laws, and then our nieces and our nephew right down there in the car seat also. This one is a close-up of me and the whole family. This is me, Ian, our son Abraham, and our daughter Allison. The reason I'm showing you guys these pictures, as well as these key tags, is because my life was not always like this. I am an addict, and just a couple days ago, I celebrated 17 months clean. Woo. And I'd like to say that the reason why I'm very grateful for my family and the time that I do have clean is because at one point I did not have them. I was too wrapped up in my addiction, and I lost everything that I loved and everyone that I did love that loved me as well. This is my first quarter here, and when I got here, I did not think that I belonged here. I felt really out of place. I felt like because of my past that I was not able to be successful. I doubted myself, and because of this class that has helped me break that, you know, break my shell and totally come out of my shell, and I appreciate that a lot. So I went with the three learned topics that I will continue to use. 32-day commitment. At first, I was really, really hesitant about that one. I was like, what? He wants us to pick something to, you know, really work on and grow from, you know, for 32 days. And I went with eating healthy. And that really worked for me because of the fact that once I started going here, I had started eating fast food, like, every day. And my truck was full of fast food bags. And every time I'd pull up and get home, Ian would look in my car and he'd go, what are you doing? You are just, you know, blowing unnecessary money and this is not right. The fact is that you are not eating healthy anymore. So that 32-day commitment really helped me get back on track because I chose to start cooking dinner, a healthy dinner every night again. And I was able to do that with a 32-day commitment. Another assignment that I will continue to use is assessing your spending. I like the fact that we sat down and we got to write out what it is exactly we spend our money on, and we got to see the negative things that we spend our money on as well as the positive things that we spend our money on. I was able to present that to the class up on the board, and Mr. Cameron ended up making me come back up and add it all up for how much it is, you know, through not just throughout the month but throughout the year. And then doubled, or what did he do? He had me times it by the years that I will be going to college, and if I could cut back all of that unnecessary spending, how much money that I would really have that could go towards a home for my spouse and I, because that is what I had said that I would like my money to go towards that I was spending unnecessarily. I also liked the eating on a budget, because that helped with my 32-day commitment as well. I was able to go to the store, pick out really cheap and easy meal plans that were as well healthy versus just, like I said, going to these fast food places or going and just picking up easy to go things, which I've kind of started slacking on a little bit again because it is the end of the quarter, I'm going to be honest. And yeah, I really will continue to use those. I like those assignments. And three challenges I overcame. Feeling out of place. I touched base on the fact that because I am an addict and because I spent a long period of my life using and not doing what I was supposed to do and not growing and being an active member of society, when I got here, I didn't feel like I fit. I felt like I was out of place. I didn't feel like I was worthy to be here. I had a lot of self-defeating thoughts, and I remember in the beginning of this class, Mr. Cameron had made us write out some challenges that we thought we were going to face, and I put self-defeating thoughts, low self-esteem about being here, and he challenged me, and he questioned me, you know, and he made me really think about why is it that you feel that way, and what can you do to make yourself not feel that way, and I took suggestions, and I appreciate him for doing that because he was super welcoming. You know, everyone in this classroom has been really supportive of me since I've been here. I've shared a bit of my story with you guys, and appreciate you guys. It helped me a lot to feel like I can succeed in and like I do belong here and I no longer feel that way. And not wanting to ask for help, really hesitant about asking for help. I thought that I, you know what I mean, I could just kind of do everything on my own, and I had it kind of down and packed. It wasn't until Mr. Cameron shared his story about not asking for help and how he was not very successful in doing that. So I started to open up a little bit, and once I did, it became second nature to do it. First nature to do it, it wasn't that hard. Once I started asking for help and taking advice, it was actually way more beneficial than trying to do everything on my own. And lack of internet. At my house, I do not have internet. And every time I would come to school, I'd come to class, and I would try to run and get off the campus as soon as possible. Because like I said, I didn't feel like I belonged here. I felt really out of place. And something that really stuck with me, Mr. Cameron had said to the entire class, he said, why would you come here and then bolt and run as soon as class is over? You have all the resources here to succeed. That's like leaving, you know what I mean? You're leaving the place that's going to help you the most. And so as much as I didn't like it and as uncomfortable as it was, I started forcing myself to go to the library and check it out. Ever since we did the scavenger hunt and we got a tour of the campus, I kind of started, you know, forcing myself to go to these little places. And, you know, even though I wasn't asking for help there, I was able to use my resources, use the internet, use the computer, go to the library and look up books, ask the librarian for assistance, ask her to print me off, you know, scholarly articles. And that really helped my situation. And then the last one that I chose was how I realized three areas that I needed to improve. And I went with the 64 question assessment. In the beginning of class, we had sat down and did a 64 question assessment. And my three bottom scores at the beginning of the quarter were employing interdependence, lifelong learning, and within myself. And I really liked that at the end of the quarter, he had us sit down and do that exact same 64 question assessment. Because with that being done, I was able to see the improvement with my three low scores as well. Even though they were still three low scores, they had improved and they had gotten higher from what they were at the beginning of this quarter. So I went with employing interdependence, I went from a 50 to a 61. Lifelong learning, I went from a 57 to a 77. And in myself, I went from a 63 to a 70. And those are, you know, weaknesses that I'm going to have to continue to work on, but throughout the quarter, they have definitely, my scores got higher. And within myself, I do feel like employing interdependence and lifelong learning and my confidence within myself has definitely raised, not just from this class, but just from being here on this campus. I feel like I can succeed today. I don't feel like my past defines me anymore. I'm able to grow from my decisions that I made in the past, and I'm able to be successful in whatever I choose to do. And that's it for me.
All right.
Thank you.
Questions, comments, thoughts for... Oh, wait, you can't leave.
I'm not leaving.
Oh.
That's it. Oh, wait, oh, that's right. Yeah. That's what you mean by leaving.
Questions.
Okay. Comments, thoughts for Tiana.
Okay.
What was your memento?
My memento was the NA tax, and they are for... Let me grab them really quick, and I'll explain them.
Okay, so the first one, excuse me,
sorry.
No, you're fine.
The first one is just for today, and that's for just if you have for 24 hours clean. And then the second one is 30 days clean. These are just milestones that you hit throughout recovery. This one is for 60 days. The next is for 90. And then you got 6 months, 9 months, and a year, and it glows in the dark so that you can find yourself, so you can find yourself even when you don't want to, kind of thing is what they say. It's really silly, but... The next one is multiples of years, and so even though they're very silly and I don't keep them on my own keychain just because of how gaudy they are, I do like to hold on to them and I keep them with me. They're in my backpack at all times so that I can kind of look at them and get a reminder of why I'm here, what it is exactly I'm doing, like what I don't want to ever go back to. And that was my memento there. A big part of my life. Also, my 1 year clean, I got just 3 weeks before my mom died. So I, at first, I didn't go and I didn't get these. I didn't like going and getting them, you know what I mean? I wasn't really, I'm not really, like, big when it comes to going to meetings and having to sit there and share about how I feel in front of a bunch of people that I don't really know. Like, I like going to my groups, like, in from my outpatient. That's where I get my support from. But after my mom passed away, that's when I started going to the groups more because I realized, like, maybe I do need to be able to just go sit amongst people who I don't know and be able to just vent and say how I feel versus feeling like I'm going to be a liability to the people around me that care about me. I don't want to, you know what I mean? I don't want to burden them. So, yep, my memento, and that's why they're special to me.
Other questions, comments, and thoughts? What will we do next quarter if doubt or something like that affects people?
No, I will. I will continue to reach out to my peers, like the people in my class. It's gonna take me a minute to adjust to the people in my classrooms again. You know what I mean? Just like with anything new that I do, I'm always like really hesitant about it. But instead of having that negative self-doubt because I have succeeded this quarter, I feel like it'll be a little easier to have the self-esteem to go in there like ready and like, okay, I got this. I, you know, my first quarter I succeeded and I did everything that I was supposed to do, so this is just going to be a breeze kind of a thing, you know. But of course I'm still going to have that negative self-doubt, but I just will have to overcome it by positive, you know, positive affirmations and you got this, you can do it, you're worth it, you've already started, why end now kind of a thing. So
what's your degree in?
I'm going for business. So next quarter, I'm going to be taking business law. I wanted to take intro to business, but that there was a clash for the times. So I'm going to, there was a clash with my schedule. So I'm going to go with for business law and see how I like it. I'm really happy about that, really excited about that decision. At first, I was going to go for human services, but I have too much empathy when it comes to that subject, especially because I am an addict in recovery, and I feel like I would have problems putting up those healthy boundaries. I feel like I would just want to help everybody, be like, oh, honey, here's this money, just go ahead and take it, I get it, you know what I mean? And so it would be hard for me to set up those healthy boundaries, and if people were to go back out and start using and or die in addiction, I feel like that would hit too close to home for me because I have lost a brother-in-law, I've lost my brother-in-law to addiction, I've lost my grandmother to addiction, I've lost my mother to addiction. So I feel like that might not be the best choice for me, so I decided to go with business instead.
Yeah. You talked about the three learned topics.
Yes.
And they're very related. Right? So
yes.
The 32-day commitment, the assessing your spending, mm-hmm. the eating budget. I mean, there's a very direct correlation.
Absolutely.
Right? But what else can you take from that? So aside from just eating healthy and, you know, effectively being frugal with your money, what other skills or benefits can you pull out of that?
So with the 32-day commitment, when it comes to, like, making dinner every night and everything, I started to, towards the end of the 32-day commitment, I had started to incorporate breakfast in there as well. So certain mornings when I'd get up and I would have enough time, if I wasn't like running late or trying to, you know, hurry up and get out the door, I would make myself some breakfast at home, you know what I mean? And I'd spoke with you about that as well, where it started becoming a habit that it wasn't only just the 32-day commitment for dinner. It became healthy snacking throughout the day, as well as making breakfast, as well as, you know what I mean, trying to meal plan. And so these are things that, you know, like I said, I'm not just going to, it's not just something that's like, oh, 32-day commitment, now it's over, I'm not going to do it. These are things that I can continue to use, as well as the budgeting. I actually have been, like, a little, started to become a bit of a stickler on my own self. I have the last of my financial aid that has just been sitting in my bank account, and I have not touched it for, like, the last 3 weeks, ever since I found out how much was in there. And it's not really hard. It's just like, nope, I don't want to go below that amount of money. You know what I mean? I'm going to let that sit there, and I will use, you know, my other money that I have, and that's going to just sit there set aside. It wouldn't have happened before. Before I would have been like, oh, we have this amount of money. It's okay. You know what I mean? So it really has helped me, the assessing the spending, having hit the brakes a little bit and be like, nope, that needs to sit aside for a bit.
Okay. Another follow-up there. So how can eating healthy and saving your money, how can that help you academically?
Well, as a student, especially with the financial aid, like I was saying, academically eating healthy, I mean, I can tell the difference when I'm sitting there and I'm eating a bunch of fast food. I feel weighed down, I feel tired, I don't have the energy versus eating healthy. It's like I'm ready for my day, I'm on the go, I'm able to focus, I'm able to study, and it's just a different feeling. It's like fueling your body with, you know what I mean? You're fueling your body with a bunch of crap, you're kind of sluggish, you're not really wanting to do much versus fueling your body with good food, steamed vegetables, steamed meats, you know what I mean? You have a little bit more energy, a little bit more pep in your step.
You mentioned that you don't have internet at home. Mm-hmm. Have you looked into some of the student internet programs?
Okay, so I live in Women and Children's Clean and Sober Housing, and so we've been trying to get internet over there, and they said that what the problem is that the turnover rate for, you know, people moving in and out, it's hard for them to just get it, you know what I mean, get it set in stone and price and everything, because they don't know if someone's just going to move out, or if, you know, once you get grounded, you're going to move out and whatnot. And that's kind of where I am right now, is I'm getting ready to move out of that housing. So, and I get what they're saying, but there's a library right across the street from my house, right downtown Port Orchard, so I've also utilized that a little bit. But like I said, I try not to leave the campus until my homework is done. That's the best way for me to do it. And then also I get to rack up those work first hours while I'm at the computer lab or the library or with Mr. Cameron. And so, yeah.
Any final questions or thoughts or comments? All right, applause.